You're innocent. Norbi Kiss, the most innocent. That's why you're...
Budapest is the venue for the fifth FIA ETRC race weekend, packed with heated discussions, great battles on the track and boiling emotions.
One result. It's not going to change the world. I'm fine. I'm perfect. You're the one that approached me.
Norbi, when you win, learn to lose gracefully.
Budapest, the capital of Hungary, is the venue for races 17, 18, 19 and 20 this season. It's the third Hungary Truck Fest at the Hungaroring, another highlight on the FIA ETRC calendar. Thursday afternoon's truck parade from the circuit into the city is one of the coolest promotional events of the entire season. Norbert Kiss leads the parade, creating lots of smoke at Heroes Square. The drivers are up close and personal with thousands of fans, and the Hungarian two-time champion takes time out for an autograph, a smile or a photo with each of them.
Look at this, all this. I mean, it's a very good event. It's very good to be close to the people, so yeah, I love it.
And but I think you're focused on the races so far now.
Not yet, maybe tomorrow.
Norbert Kiss is not the only personality signing autographs. The Hungarians are great motorsport enthusiasts. The road to the circuit is closed for the journey there and back. Green lights thanks to the Budapest police motorcyclists. After his fantastic display and two victories at the Slovakia Ring, Norbert Kiss is the centre of attention at the Hungaroring, and he enjoys it.
This is good because it takes my mind off the technical things and everything. So when the qualifying comes, you know, I just sit in and drive and it should be okay.
The local hero travels to Hungary lying second overall. Will he cut the gap to leader Adam Lacko and live up to the hopes of his many fans here?
I think it's the victory, which last year I couldn't make in only second place two times. But yeah, this year I think we have more chance because we are better than the previous year, because obviously the team worked really hard to improve the track and everything.
Two Germans are also chasing Lacko, Steffi Halm and Jochen Hahn. Halm lying fourth overall won a race here last season. Jochen Hahn lying third, clocked up two victories at the Hungaroring in 2016.
So now we have no time for mistakes. That's the point. Everybody walk in the break, in the 6 weeks holiday. We walk on the track, everybody. And now, what we have now, we must build the last five races.
Yeah, now it's a very short time, but many races, and like in the beginning, in the first half of the season, you have to score as many points as possible. Don't have an accident, no technical problems, don't make any mistakes to get any penalties. So, yeah, I think the most important thing is to stay constant and score as many points as possible.
But this man will do everything to prevent that. Adam Lacko, boasting 6 victories and 10 podium finishes this season and taking points in every single race, Lacko has dominated the ETRC so far this term. Will he pick up where he left off before the 6-week summer break?
I think every point counting from the start of the season is very important, every point. But when we come to closer to the end, it's more important when you have some more points or not. And when it comes to the finish, we must look more and more to the points.
Qualifying on Saturday is the first serious test, and it's an easy affair for Norbert Kiss. The Hungarian is the fastest driver on the 4.4-kilometre track, his Mercedes-Benz truck setting a 2-minute 18.5-second lap time. After his lap, Lacko is surprised he was 8-tenths faster than Jochen Hahn, Steffi Halm and Adam Lacko.
I know I made a mistake. I'm pretty sure that they made a mistake also. So I think probably it's not a qualifying that all of us in the top 3 or 5 are proud of, because I'm pretty sure everybody made a mistake.
Norbert Kiss will be starting race one at the Hungaroring from pole, surrounded by the media. Jochen Hahn will be lining up alongside him. The reigning champion will be on the slower outside line at the start.
Yes, I am on the inside, and I think with Johan we are quite even on engine power, as it looked like in Slovakia. So I think I have a good chance. If I don't make any mistake and have a good start, then I think I'll have a good chance of making turn one. But you know, it's a motorsport. Anything can happen. Anything can go wrong. I can make a mistake, but I hope not. I will try my best for sure.
The only woman in the competition, Steffi Halm, will be starting directly behind Kiss. Her blue Rhino racing truck was fractionally faster than Adam Lacko's Freightliner, number 55. Lacko is not certain how the race will go for him. Surprisingly far down the order in P14 is Ryan Smith, who announced he would win a race this weekend.
I make a mistake. I thought the qualifying session was 20 minutes and instead 10, so I don't do a fast lap. And, you know, a little disappointed, but, you know, we won't finish 15th.
Race one is on. The 5.5-ton race trucks will cover 11 laps in each of the four races at the Hungaroring. On board with Adam Lacko, who has a poor getaway. Kiss and Hahn alongside each other in turn one. Guest driver Shane Brereton passes Lacko, and Lacko struggles to retain his position. Antonio Albafetti gets in on the act and shovels him towards the grass. Fourth to eighth, Brereton, Albafetti, Lacko, Lentz and Jose Rodriguez. Lacko's teammate David Vrsecky gets hit at the start. His rear camera shows Ryan Smith's yellow truck number 88 staging a manoeuvre against Andre Kurzim's silver and red truck number 42. At the beginning of lap two, Lacko attacks Albafetti, passing the Spaniard in his red and white truck on the inside of turn one for P5. Race leader Norbert Kiss is followed by Jochen Hahn and Steffi Halm. On board with Ryan Smith, who moved up two positions on lap one, now passing Andre Kurzim for P11.
We had good fights. We passed, you know, the Bagheera, Gert Korber, Rodriguez very fast. You know, we tried to make it entertaining, and I hope it went well.
Smith's compatriot Shane Brereton too is entertaining the fans. Sixth in qualifying, now lying fourth. He does everything to retain his position against overall leader Lacko. Ryan Smith is moving through the pack. Having passed Vrsecky and Kurba, now he overtakes Jose Rodriguez for eighth on lap nine. Norbert Kiss proves a cool customer, taking the flag 7.5 seconds ahead of Jochen Hahn and 10.5 ahead of Steffi Halm, fully meeting his fans' expectations. Kiss receives rapturous celebrations, even though he lost track of things towards the end of the race.
I think in the last two or three laps, I was asking Stefan, because the counter was not working. Usually there's a counter that shows the lap remaining, but it was not working this time, so I didn't know. So I started to ask, and it was still two or three laps. And I said, long race. But I'm really happy. It's really good to be back on the podium, especially on the first step of the podium, especially here in the Hungaroring. I'm really happy.
The third triumph for Norbert Kiss, 20 championship points and a trophy that will surely occupy a special place at his home. More than 30,000 fans are pleased for the local hero, who is celebrating his victory. The result at a glance. Winner Kiss. Lacko finishing fourth as Shane Brereton incurred a 20-second penalty after the race and was demoted to 10th for speeding as he went faster than the permitted 160 km/h maximum. The Hungary Truck Fest does not only mean truck racing action. The motocross event, for example, provided great entertainment for all those whose interests are not restricted to trucks. Reverse grid order for race two on Saturday late afternoon. The top eight swap positions. David Vrsecky, who has a chance of winning races, is ahead of Gert Kurber, who is still working on his setup. Ryan Smith is third alongside Sasha Lenz. The Brit is also a serious contender for the race win.
Gert is a very experienced driver. David is also a very experienced driver. You know, it needs to be done early. If it's done early, then I will be gone. But, you know, if they back me up into Adam and Sasha and Steffi, then maybe I will come under pressure. But, you know, I will be attacking early.
Norbert Kiss, winner of the first race, takes his time on the grid, leaving his truck for a photo. The second race of the day is usually more spectacular than the first one, as the supposedly better drivers have to fight their way up the order. And the special race is on. On board with Jochen Hahn, who takes turn one, lying sixth, with Ryan Smith dropping from third to eighth. Jose Rodriguez from Portugal, the overall Amateur Promoters Cup leader, retires after turn one, following contact with his rival André Kurzim. But Kurzim cannot be blamed for causing the collision intentionally. The drivers are close, everyone fighting for the best line. Kiss in a battle for P6 with Steffi Halm. Adam Lacko easily passes his teammate David Vrsecky, who makes way for the Bagheera team's number one driver and then acts as a buffer between Lacko and the rest of the field. Kiss against Smith. The latter aims to pass, but Kiss puts up a fight and is hit by the English trucker. On board with Smith. You can see the contact. Kiss is forced to countersteer, honking his horn angrily. The many Kiss fans are disappointed as he retires with a broken front spring.
The fight with Norbi, you know, he should have given me more room. And if he gave me more room, we go round the corner together. But some people like Norbi don't want to give the position up, you know. They sometimes believe they are, you know, the hierarchy than everyone. But, you know, Norbi is a very good driver.
I try to leave him space. Okay, not the whole circuit, but I think I leave him enough space for one track so that he can make the turn. But I think he braked too late and he was a little too fast entering the turn five and couldn't keep his line. But you know, it's really hard to tell. We looked at some videos and everything, and it's really hard to tell.
The race continues without Norbert Kiss, with Jochen Hahn staging a ferocious attack against David Vrsecky, a four-time champion from Germany in a battle with a two-time champion from the Czech Republic. Hahn forces his way past Vrsecky, but is within the admissible limits for truckers. The race order, Lacko ahead of Hahn and Vrsecky. The same turn, two laps later. Lacko stays on the inside, leaving Hahn no chance to find a gap. Jochen Hahn pushes to his limits. Ryan Smith in P4, close to Vrsecky. Around 10 seconds behind them, the battle for P5. Gert Kuber, Steffi Halm, Shane Brereton and Antonio Albacete. Halm overtakes Kuber for P5 shortly before the end of the race. Vrsecky and Smith are side by side as Lacko crosses the finishing line 6 tenths ahead of Jochen Hahn in P2. Last lap, Ryan Smith stages his final attack to pass David Vrsecky, who probably didn't anticipate a manoeuvre at this point. Smith finishes third, completing the podium. Lacko and Hahn are not the only drivers who have some explaining to do after the race.
It's very special because every time we have bad luck here, and today we have a good luck and I finish on the first position and I'm very happy with this.
Adam Lacko clinches his 7th victory this season, taking 10 points and celebrating 2 successful races along with Jochen Hahn and Ryan Smith. The Brit records his first podium finish and Jochen Hahn is satisfied.
You know, the plan is to win every time, but for nobody is possible to win every race. No, from the speed we are second today and we 2 times the second place, so it's a real speed and I'm very happy with the results today.
The result at a glance, Vrsecky in P4, Hahn in P5, Albacete 6th and Shane Brereton finishing 7th. The best Promoters Cup driver. There's straight talking from Ryan Smith and Norbert Kiss after the podium ceremony.
In the second race, in the reverse grid race, I never expect to win or, you know, whatever. But yeah, for sure lose like this, that you can't finish your race, is not good. I think he was just upset because obviously the people booed him on the podium. So. That's never good.
To be a fantastic winner, you've also got to be a fantastic loser. You know, I am graceful when I win and when I lose.
A day packed with action comes to an end. The chances are that the Hungary Truck Fest will be just as spectacular on Sunday. It is hotter on the second day, more than 30 degrees. Tolerable for the fans, but a sweat-laden affair for the drivers. Norbert Kiss clinches the 2nd pole and is duly celebrated by his fans. Overall leader Adam Lacko will be lining up alongside him on the front row. Steffi Halm is 3rd on the grid, Jochen Hahn 4th, and they share the 2nd row.
I will give my best. I will try to have a good start. Maybe I can gain a position, but for sure I want to keep the 3rd place. But yeah, on the straight at the start, all depends on the reaction. Normally it should be good, but you know, it's difficult when Norbi is in front of you because he's a little bit slower.
There's growing excitement for fans, big and small. The start from Antonio Albacete's roof cam. Norbert Kiss slows down. Steffi Halm is delayed as well on the run towards turn 1 as predicted. Adam Lacko's rear camera reveals tight battles everywhere. Erwin Kleinnagelvoort hits Ryan Smith's rear, the latter incurring tyre damage. Up front, it's Kiss and Lacko in the battle for the lead. Steffi Halm in 3rd watches Adam Lacko pass Norbert Kiss for the lead of the race. Ryan Smith is forced to retire following a lap of smoke signals. His tyre completely disintegrates. The airborne debris hit the cover of his cooling system and that puts him out. It's an unusual turn of events. Kiss puts leader Lacko under pressure. Thousands of fans closely watching the battle at the Hungaroring. Shane Brereton turns in another fantastic display, coming 6th, followed by Sascha Lenz and sealing another Promoters' Cup victory. Frankie Wojciech is out of luck, retiring after 7 of the 11 laps with a technical problem. Jochen Hahn goes to his limits again but fails to overtake Antonio Albertetti for 4th place. Norbert Kiss chases Adam Lacko's Bagheera Freightliner from lights to flag but ultimately fails to pass the check. Lacko wins race 3 at the Hungaroring and is seemingly unstoppable on the way to his first European Championship title. Norbert Kiss finishes second, with Steffi Halm completing the podium. Lacko notches up his 8th victory this term, but the Czech was actually struggling with hidden technical problems. His win was not a matter of course.
Before the end of the race, 2-3 laps, I have overheat the brakes. I try a little bit cool down, but Norbi still is behind me and it's not possible to go slower. And I must push like hell and control Norbi behind me. And on the finish, it's coming the first place and I'm very happy with this.
Lacko beats Kiss and Halm to the finish line. The result in blue and white. Behind them, Albertetti fourth ahead of Hahn fifth and Shane Brereton in sixth spot. The ETRC drivers have to write as fast as they drive. Their autographs are in high demand in Hungary. Of course, Norbert Kiss's autograph is the most sought after. The 2014 and 2015 champion is in his element and signs away merrily. The last race in the late afternoon, still more than 30 degrees, with Gert Kurber as the pole sitter.
I will concentrate on a real quick start to be in the front and the braking area to can lead, let's say, some laps. It's good for the air cooling and for the water cooling. So we will see.
Shane Brereton aims to clinch his third Promoters Cup victory, and the Brit certainly has the quality to achieve it. At the start, Norbert Kiss has another poor getaway, falling behind, and is lucky not to be involved in a collision at turn 3. Jochen Hahn is responsible, pushing Brereton into Lenz, the latter spinning. Albertetti tries to avoid contact and ends up in the tyre wall. It's bad luck for the Spaniard, who is able to continue in the race, finishing 9th and taking 2 points. But he disapproves of the driving style.
I think the first corners in the second races are a little bit crazy, you know. I think that is not a mentality to see, okay, I go here. No, just go and... If we are lucky, we are lucky, and if we are not lucky, we are not lucky, you know? So I'm really upset.
Lap 2, Kurber against Lacko, who profited from the mix-up, moving up from 8th to 2nd. The two touch slightly. Lacko takes the lead. Steffi Halm too passes Kurber in lap 5 and is now chasing Adam Lacko. Norbert Kiss retires again, this time with a blocked powertrain. On lap 8, Vrsecky is against Kurber. The Czech sees a gap where there isn't one. They have problems. Kurber loses third and eventually drops out of the race. Overall leader Adam Lacko seals his third victory in Hungary and his 9th triumph overall. He's followed by Steffi Halm, who along with her team celebrates 2nd like a race win. David Vrsecky is 3rd, his first podium of the season.
On the last lap I have a big problem with the engine, with the throttle, because it's coming maybe only 15-20% of the power. But I finish with this problem also in the first position. And it's really nice, and for the last race in Hungaroring, 3rd victory, it's perfect.
The race result at a glance. Hahn finishes 4th, followed by Smith, Lenz, Brereton, Kurzim and Albertetti, with Klein Nagelvoort completing the top 10. Andre Kurzim takes the lead in the Promoters' Cup thanks to 1 victory and 3 second place finishes. Yeah. Adam Lacko now boasts 232 points overall, extending his cushion at the top of the ETRC standings to 58 points. Norbert Kiss and Jochen Hahn are his closest pursuers. Andre Kurzim is ninth ahead of Jose Rodriguez. In the second half of the table, the two Brits, Ryan Smith and Shane Brereton, are 12th and 13th. Adam Lacko from the Czech Republic is the local hero on the next FIA European Truck Racing Championship weekend, as the sixth race weekend will be staged in Mošt in the Czech Republic.